person that he was, there's nobody better. That guy gave up his life helping others. You know, and if you look up the word hero, it was someone who gives up their life helping others, and that's exactly what he did.
After his passing, Roberto becomes more than a great player, he becomes a great man.
I started an archive of photography to help Vera Clemente. This was my photography studio for 12 years, and the archive just lived in a little room upstairs. So when she came for the party, I did all this in literally a month for her party. There wasn't one thing in his space. That's kind of why we're doing what we're doing here at the museum, is because the Hurricane Hugo in the 80s flooded her house, and a bunch of her photos were ruined. And that's how I started fixing the photos for her. And so I transformed this whole space just for the event. I started giving private tours. And so I've been doing them ever since.
But he's put a lot of work in since then. The collection is constantly changing. He's buying new things and putting them on display. A lot of people don't know about the museum. And so they come in, they're not sure what to expect. And when they come in, what they see is just a gorgeous old building. And then they see all this memorabilia that Dwayne has managed to collect over time. Anytime you can get people here, that helps us spread the word. And if you're here, chances are you enjoy it.
I mean, the property, the building itself, you know, historic fire station where Lou Gehrig sleeps in 1927, kind of ties it all together with the two guys to bypass the five-year waiting list to the Hall of Fame. It's only happened to two players, and it's Gehrig and Roberto, so that's pretty cool. There's a lot of magical things going on in this property. The steel beams are 21 inches. The building was vacated on New Year's Eve of 1972 at 9 o'clock at night, pretty much the same time that plane crashed into the ocean. So maybe it's meant to be for us to be doing this. So I've met about 30 of the Clementes through the years. They're a great, great family. They've been carrying on his legacy of having that sports city in Puerto Rico was his dream. And his boys and his mother gave up pretty much most of their life to keep that place going.
317 lifetime batting average. He had about 240 career home runs, 3,000 career hits. You can't evaluate Roberto just on the statistics. You had to see him play.
A home plate from the 1971 World Series. Just because there's only one of those, you know, we talk about the Clemente cards and the graded cards, and we've got that incredible collection here on loan from a good friend of the museum. And we talk about how there's two graded 10 rookies out there and they're worth $1 million, but there's two. But we have the home plate from the 71 World Series where he's the MVP, and there's only one of those. So that's a pretty cool piece.
The angel wing photograph, which is really impactful because back in 2006, when the whole germ of the museum gets started, and Dwayne is hosting Vera Clemente for a party before the All-Star game, that's what she sees when she walks in. One item that's probably pretty unique is we have a couple of bats, including more than a couple, but we have a bat from his rookie year, 1955.
The Clemente Award, you know, when I talk to players that got the Clemente Award, they'll say that it was the greatest award they were ever given.
The fact that there is, and the fact that it's associated with not your performance on the field, but your performance off the field, is very appropriate. Every little bit, whether it's the wall, the statue, the name of the bridge, every little bit that helps keep his memory alive is a good thing.
I mean, I think it's awesome because at least when people do come to Pittsburgh, like this small museum right here, a lot of people don't know about us, but you'll go over to see the statue. Everybody goes to see that thing. Every Puerto Rican who comes to Pittsburgh goes to see that stadium and that statue. Most of his adult life, he was talking about dying in a plane in the ocean and his body wouldn't be found. All three of those things came true. Manny Sanguin, one of the players, was diving with the crew, and they found this crazy briefcase that he got in Nicaragua that had actually an alligator as the handle. A little baby alligator was the handle. And one of his friends told him that that was bad luck, and they actually found that floating in the ocean, which kind of was an eerie sign.
I was in bed, mom and dad woke me up and told me that the plane had crashed. And your first reaction is denial. You don't want to believe it. Your second reaction is that he's going to be found someplace. You went to a Pirate game that era, and Roberto was supposed to be in right field. And he wasn't there, so it takes a while. Even after you know it, you internalize it, you understand it. There's still that edge of disbelief.
So it's growing because we work very hard here to keep his name alive.
So Pittsburgh sports heroes, by and large, have been those players that not only were good, but were players that the fans knew gave their all. But Roberto, they knew he hustled on every play. When he hit the ball, he ran it out to first base. They knew he worked hard, and so he became a favorite.
I spent my whole adult life doing what I'm doing, pretty much. You know, and people, when they ask me why am I doing it, I say because I want to play catch with him when I get there. So that's kind of why I'm doing this. I must be chosen to do what I'm doing because I couldn't stop this if I wanted to. It's the person that he was. And we tell the stories more, you know, the personal stories behind the scenes and what he was doing with his life, the stories of the things that he was doing and helping kids and working, you know, the guy was incredible. The way he died is the way he lived. He spent most of the time when he wasn't playing baseball helping kids. Teaching kids life, teaching kids baseball. He's my idol. I mean, he's, you know, I live, eat, breathe Roberto Clemente every day.